A warm welcome to all of you to my channel Gear to Excel. I, Pradeep, would like to thank all of you for like, sharing and subscribing to our YouTube channel.
Our learning checklist. What we will cover in this session. If oil is sighted at the observation tank sight glass, what procedure should be carried out without affecting the main engine operation? Action to be taken in the event of gross oil contamination in the boiler. Precautions required to be taken while putting the boiler back into operation after oil contamination is rectified. So we will cover all these topics. So next, if oil is sighted at the observation tank sight glass, what procedures should be carried out without affecting the main engine operation? Let's say if there is oil sighted in a cascade or observation tank sight glass, what all the procedure and action taken to overcome that without affecting the main engine operation? So steps are: most oil leakage can be sighted at the observation tank, that's cascade tank, which is normally fitted with a sight glass, and also it has a oil observation alarm that will also give you, but sometimes it gives a false alarm even. The source of leakage then can be detected and taken care of. Possibility of contamination through leakages at the oil heaters, coolers and steam heating coils. As a precaution, carry out frequent surface or scum blowdown the boiler as far as possible. The leakages can lead to foaming, timing and carryover. It impedes heat transfer if there is a oil in the feed water system or in the boiler. The observation tank and the cascade tank have to be thoroughly cleaned, including the loofah filters. There is a filter inside that is also to be cleaned. Tank drain and tank clean properly. Any traces of oil coming to the observation tank has to be continuously removed by oil absorbent pad. Possible causes of leakage, from where the oil can come. If lube oil, then it can come from lube oil purifier steam heater or lube oil slush tank or drain tank, lube oil settling tank or sump tank heating coil, diesel oil. Not possible because we don't have any diesel oil heating. HFO. So it can come from HFO purifier, steam heater, HFO slush tank, drain tank, HFO settling tank, HFO service tank, waste oil tank, settling and service, the incinerator part, bunker tank seating, main engine HFO heater, DG or fuel oil heater, boiler fuel oil heater, slash tank. We have already seen that where all possibilities are there for oil to come into the boiler feed water system, to the cascade tank or to the boiler. So if you find the oil in the boiler, cascade tank, what actions to be taken in the event of gross oil contamination in the boiler? Number one, the boiler has to be taken out of service if there is a gross oil contamination. We must stop the boiler and taken out of the service. Oil in boiler has to come from cascade tank. The source of leak has to be immediately identified and rectified. The observation tank at cascade tank has to be cleaned thoroughly, including the loofah filters. If the presence of oil is found on the water side of the boiler, it must be removed by boiling out. Boiling out requires the boiler to be taken out of service and drained completely. For this, we have to drain the boiler completely and flush. Before draining, carry out thorough surface blowdown. Never carry out bottom blowdown first, because then it will make another layer. When you do bottom blowdown first, then water level will come, whatever oil is floating on the surface of the boiler water, that will make another layer. Boiling out is also very quick and efficient method of removing various types of skin. Boiling out to remove oil requires the use of fairly strong caustic solution. Consult your boiler chemical supplier. Maker's advice is to be taken. One such solution is 2 kg of caustic soda and 4 kg of trisodium phosphate for each 1000 kg of cold water required to fill the boiler. In addition, it is advisable to add detergent amounting to 0.5% of the boiler water capacity. After boiling, boiler is fitted with the chemical. It is then fired until it attains a pressure of about 5 bars. After boiler is filled with the chemical, it is then fired until it attains a pressure of about 5 bars. It is then completely drained and filled with the usual treatment chemicals. Caution: do not fill feed water into the boiler if the temperature difference between boiler and feed water exceeds 50 degrees Celsius. Boiling out. Before putting the boiler into operation for the first time, it should be boiled out to remove all protecting remedies and impurities on the boiler water side. This is done during commissioning of the boiler. So this is the process or procedure of boiling up. Normally it is done when the boiler commissioning is done. The boiling out procedure is to be carried out as described below. Again, question: extreme care should be taken while handling the chemicals. The person handling the chemical should use proper PPE. Fill the boiler with a solution consisting of 4 to 5 kg trisodium phosphate per 1000 kg of water. The chemical can be added through the manhole. Add feed water until the solution is visible to just above lower water level in the water gauges. Close the feed water valve, that is, and stop the pump. Slowly raise the steam to working pressure and keep the pressure for approximately 3 to 4 hours with main steam valve shut closed. Carry out scum blowdown until water level is between normal water level and high water level. Only scum blowdown. By this procedure, grease and other impurities are removed from the internal surface of the boiler. Start skimming by opening the scum valve and lower the water level to lower edge of normal water level mark. Close the scum valve. Refill the boiler with feed water and start skimming again in intervals of 30 minutes for a period of 2 hours. This process to be done for at least 2 hours with the interval of 30 minutes. Stop the boiling out procedure by shutting down the boiler burner. Allow boiler water to rest for about 5 minutes. Now carry out a final skimming. Blow down the boiler water by opening the blow down valves. Open the air vent valve to avoid a vacuum in the boiler when the boiler pressure decreases to approximately to a level of depressurized or atmospheric pressure. Please do remember to open air vent valve. Very important. Open the manhole and allow the boiler to cool down to a pressure 100 degrees Celsius. The boiler is to be flushed with clean water on the boiler water side when the temperature has decreased. The flushing will remove the remaining impurities. Dismantle, clean and inspect the bottom blowdown valve because deposits of foreign substances will usually be accumulated in these valves and might cause leaking if it is not cleaned. So we must dismantle, clean and inspect the bottom blowdown valve prior taking water. Inspect the boiler and remove any remaining deposits and foreign substances. Finally, new gaskets to be fitted in all hand and manholes before refilling the boiler water with to upper edge of low water level. The boiler is now ready to be taken into service. Note, during the first 2 weeks in operation, carry out frequent skimming and bottom blowdown to remove impurities entering the boiler valve from the pipe system. Thank you. For further topics, please do subscribe our YouTube channel Gear to Action. Thank you once again. Thanks a lot for watching. Have a great day.